Welcome to another episode of Your Motivation for Today. And I am speaking on you get what you believe you deserve. Yes, you are such a good person. Always trying the best you can to live a moral and righteous life. Never intentionally hurting anyone. And making great efforts to be your neighbor's keeper. And yet, many a time you wonder why the good things of life you think and feel you deserve do not come your way. You see other people that you think that you are better off than hitting it well on life. But you, things don't go the same way for you. And you wonder why. Well, the truth of the matter is that you are not going to get anything out of life that you don't really believe. Now, this belief is not the one that you mouth. It is the one that you fervently hold and relate in it on a daily basis. It is not enough in life to live morally and ethically. You must also be mentally straight. You must have a positive self-image in order to receive the blessings of life. I often ask the question, why do the righteous suffer? In other words, why do seemingly good people suffer? You can be morally and ethically straight and correct, but if you do not know how to positively relate to your emotions and the processes of your mind, you will suffer. So it's not enough just to be a good person. You must have a proper self-identity. You must fervently believe that you deserve God's goodness. So the question again, why do good people suffer? And the answer is because they don't believe that they deserve God's goodness. Yes, they ask for God's goodness in their prayers, but deep down in their minds, they don't believe they deserve it. They doubt it. So if you don't believe you deserve God's goodness, what then do you believe? At the subconscious level, are you believing that you deserve the opposite of good? Maybe that is why you are not getting the good that you deserve. So today, make a special appeal to yourself. To not only think but believe that you deserve God's goodness. Because you are a child of God and He has given you all that you need to be in this planet. Make a great effort to appropriate yourself those good things that God has already given to you. So that's it for today. Until I come your way again in the next episode, the name has not changed. It is Dr. Jerry the First Oguzie, JP. See you again. Welcome to another episode of Your Motivation for Today. And I'm speaking on a fearful mind will always draw something. As you all know, coronavirus is on the rampage all over the world. And many a man has become afraid of going out to public places and crowded places. That is a sensible thing to do, right? Yes, right. However, 2 days ago, I met a man in his 70s who said he was not afraid of the virus because he knows that God will not allow him to be infected since he is a child of God. So I asked him if he would willingly allow himself to be put in close contact with a confirmed coronavirus patient. And he replied that he would do no such thing because he does not want to offend God. So I put it to him that one is a beaten fear of contracting the virus. Those of us who are Christians and who are very conversant with the story of Job in the Bible will remember that God was very proud of Job because he was a man after his own merit. thus God allowed Satan to tempt Job. And so, in one fell swoop, just in one day, all that Job had labored for all his life went into flaming fire. Job's children were taken away, his health was taken away, and his wealth was taken away. Now, why did all these things happen to Job, a righteous man? I ask you, was Job really righteous? Meaning, was he right thinking? Or was he simply religious? Meaning, carrying touch of his faith? When Job got the news of vanishing earthly possessions, he declared, "The thing I greatly feared has come upon me." And that is exactly what got Job. The thing he feared. Just like some of us, you don't know why you feel so bad, or you go around afraid of what might happen. You're filled with worry and anxiety. You go around with your feelings dragging in the dirt. So like I said last time, it isn't enough to be smaller than everyone. You must have the correct self-awareness. You must know yourself and learn how to control your thoughts and feelings. This is what I mean by writing. You must be mentally straight. You have to learn how to lift up your feelings, how to lift up your emotions. You have to learn how to control your thoughts and your feelings and beliefs about yourself. You have to learn to go inside of yourself and develop a positive self-image and a positive self-esteem. That is the only time you can ask and you will be given. I'll see you again in the next episode. My name is Dr. Jerry the First.
Again to another episode of Motivation for Today, and I have titled this talk, "Nothing Can Come to You Unless You Draw It." Many times things happen to good religious people and people who think that they are righteous, and they don't understand why. They say, "Now, why would this person do me out of this? Why do these things happen to me?" If somebody is always doing you out of something, watch out. It means that somewhere in your subconscious psychology, there is some kind of negative belief. It could be the belief that you are not deserving that thing. And nothing can come to you unless you believe that you deserve it. And nothing can go from you unless you believe that you don't deserve it. You're not going to get anything that you don't really believe that you deserve. And if you do appear to get something that you really think you don't deserve, you think it's too good for you, don't worry, it will slip away before you wake up from sleep, because somebody else will come along and take it off your hands. So it is very important that you think that you deserve the best. You are a child of God. Your belief about yourself should be based upon your knowledge of who and what you are in God, and who and what God is in you. So, you deserve the best because you are a child of God. And the earlier you believe it, the better. So from today and onwards, believe that you deserve the best. And whatever it is that you want, draw that thing out to yourself. The only way to draw is not by using your physical hands to draw. You can draw things spiritually. You can draw things using your mouth. Remember, we said that your mouth, the words that proceed out of your mouth, are very powerful. And you're creating your new world every day with the mouth, with the things you say from your mouth. So draw the things that you want onto yourself and they will come. If you keep quiet about them, your destiny will be quiet. Build your destiny. It is in your hands. That's it for today. My name is Dr. Jerry the First Oluzie. I'll see you again in the next episode.